Hello and welcome to PDFSupply.com. Today we're going to be testing an Allen Bradley PLC5 processor. I have here an L80B Series E. What we're going to be testing is to get the processor into run mode and check for any faults. And we're going to be testing it particularly in this video through channel zero, which is right here. I'm going to get into that in a moment. So this test should be the same for just about any L80. This one happens to be an enhanced, it's not an Ethernet module. There will be a video for that as well. But as far as the channel zero is concerned, this should be your only, the real issue here. So what I have is a 1771 P4S power supply, and it's in a 1771 A1B four slot chassis is what I'm using for a rack. So what we're going to do is we have two softwares to be concerned with, and I'm going to open them up right now. First one is RSLynx Classic Lite. This is, for those of you who don't already know, the software that goes in between the RS Logix 5 software and the computer, and it makes a communication path between the computer and the processor. So this is necessary. I typically open this up first. And now that I am connected, what I'm going to do is I'm going to click on the configure drivers icon, which is usually located on the top left side. It's a squiggly line with two leads at the end. It looks like a computer wire. I'm going to click on that. It says configure drivers. And then I'm going to go to the actual configure button, click on that. And a third window will pop open. It says configure, in this particular case, RS-231 DF1 device driver. And I'm going to select auto configure, we call it the cheat button, and it will go ahead and change any of the, as long as you're on the right communication port, it will go ahead and change baud rate, parity, stop bits, device type on its own. And that's why we call it a cheat button. So once that says auto configuration successful, I'm going to click OK. Now, if you don't already have a communication path, when you open up configure drivers, it on the top left-hand side, it'll say available driver types. So in this particular case, it's RS-232 DF1 devices. Okay, that's the communication for here, RS-232. All right. Now that that's configured, I'm going to keep RS Classics Lite open, but I'm going to reduce it, and now I'm going to open my RS Logix 5 software. Once that's open, I'm going to go to File, select New, and then from the left to the right, we have a window that pops open and says Select Processor Type, Platform is Enhanced. Processor is PLC580. And I'm going to go ahead and select OK. Now, if there's any changes that need to be made to any of the other selections under processor type, it'll automatically be done when you go to attempt a download. So I'm going to click OK. And here's a point where you can make some changes. For this particular test, I'm going to leave the configuration of the channel at 2400 baud, which is kind of slow. If you decide that you want to communicate at a faster rate, you can open up channel configuration in the left-hand side. Edit channel properties window will pop open, channel zero. If you go to serial port, baud rate, there's a drop-down menu that allows you to communicate up to 19,200 baud, 19.2K. And if you choose, you can select that, communicate faster. But again, for this test, I'm just going to communicate at the 2400 default. Next thing is in the top left-hand side where there's a drop-down menu that should say offline for all of you. If you click that, it gives you choices to go online, online now, download, partial download. We're going to go to download. All right. Now, we haven't put anything in the I/O configuration because there is nothing here. This is just a test on the processor. So, of course, we're not technically downloading anything other than the L80. And our goal is to get it into run mode and keep it in run mode. All right. So right away it's giving me that this Series A Rev B is not particularly the case, and mine's a Series E Rev F. So I'm going to go ahead and select OK, and I'm selecting OK to change that. And it's going to resize my data tables. This is just what I mentioned before that may come up if you don't select the exact Rev and Series. It'll select it for you. Then you can go ahead with that. Next, it's going to be downloading processor image. That'll take a few minutes. And we can see that there's communication going on here, so I know my port is working well. Next, it's going to ask you if you want to save this file. I usually do. I just call it PLC5L80Test. And select Save. And then it's going to ask me if I want to go online because it is now completed downloading. Yes. All right. On the RS Logix 5 software, it's showing me that it has a bluish-green program. So it's gone from offline to program. Now we're online. Our communication path is complete between the computer and the processor. And if I want to, based on what I downloaded, I can go into run mode, which is what we want to do. So I'm going to go ahead, go to remote run. Okay. So now I'm in run mode, but it's in remote run, not in hard run. Okay. Next thing I want to do is go to and bear with me as this opens up. My processor status. So I'm going to double click under controller on processor status. And what I'm going to do is go over to errors. So you'll have a window that pops open that says file S2 status. And then there'll be tabs at the top, main, MCP, scan times, math, switches, errors. I'm going to go to errors and find out if there's any errors, major errors, error codes. Then I'm going to find out if there are any errors, what they are, what they pertain to. And if it's nothing major, I can go ahead and click a button that says at the bottom left, it says clear major errors if you are having a problem. Then I'm going to go next tab is processor warning, program warning, and I can continue to scroll through to the right any other information that I want to see, channel warning, anything that could be wrong with the processor. Okay. So if I don't see anything major, next thing that I might do is leave the processor in run mode, remote run, like you see here. It doesn't have to be in hard run for the test that we're doing. And we want to see that the processor is able to sustain itself in run mode for a couple days, 2 or 3 days, maybe over a weekend. You could put other modules next to it. You could create a situation where it's hotter by blocking off the airflow a little bit to maybe put it under load a little and see that it's able to sustain. That's just a couple things that we would do. Now, if it remains in run mode, we typically think that it's a good working processor. If it fails, then we'll look a little bit deeper into it. We'll see exactly if we can find out through the processor status what the error was, why it failed. We may take a deeper look at it. And this is actually something that we do repair here at PDF Electric and Supply if you do have a problem. We offer exchange programs, new and remanufactured products, and also same day shipping. So if that's something that you need or interests you, please see us at pdfsupply.com. Thank you.